Hello everyone, welcome to Bhadra IAS. My name is Asaswari Goswami. We are discussing prelims 2021 answer key. I have experience of 5 UPSC interviews, 6 times I have cleared prelims. In this video, we are discussing questions of history asked in prelims 2021 GS paper. So let us start. First question, with reference to the history of ancient India, Bhavbhuti, Hastimalla, Chameswara were famous playwrights. So, one may not be aware of others like Hastimalla and Chameswara, but Bhavbhuti is well known. Name is given in NCERT also. So, you must be aware of ancient Indian great playwrights of Sanskrit like Kalidas, Bhavbhuti, Sudrak, Bhasa. So, all these great Sanskrit playwrights from ancient India, we should be aware of. So, even if you know this name, Bhavbhuti, you can mark B as the answer. Next is Montagu, James IV reforms of 1990. So, statement one is saying that it recommended granting voting rights to all women above age of 21. So, basically it is talking about universal franchise for women in India in 1919. Universal adult franchise for women even in Europe was achieved in around 1930s and after these years. So this statement is obvious incorrect. Even if you don't know this directly, you can eliminate one. Government of India Act 1935 gave women reserved seat in the legislature. This is true. During the roundtable conference 1, 2, 3, many things were discussed and many sections of society got reserved seat, like women, Anglo-Indian, Sikh, Muslim. This statement is true. Next, 8 August 1942, basically it was linked to Quit India resolution adopted by All India Congress Committee. So this is again a very simple question from modern history. So, Quit India Revolution is also known as August Kranti also. So, from that we can say that answer is A. Songs from Prison. Again, this is a question linked to 1930s only. So, this translation of ancient Indian lyrics was done by Mahatma Gandhi. So, we know that Tilak was linked to religious activities, but not like writing songs. Sarojini Naidu, she was also famous for her lyrical poetry, but she was not into religious themes. She was a romantic. Jawaharlal Nehru, he wrote Discovery of India, but not religious lyrics. So we can, from this also we can say that Mahatma Gandhi is the most probable person. He wrote these songs in Yerawada prison. And if one is aware that Mahatma Gandhi was a big fan of Narsimha Mehta's religious devotional song, that is Vaishnav Janto. So from that also we can guess that most probable answer should be Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi. With reference to the medieval India, which one of the following is correct sequence in ascending order in terms of their size? This is a very simple question from medieval India. So we know that Mughal Empire was divided in various Subas. Suba means, you can say, state. Below that, Sarkar, so which is something like modern day district. Below that, Pargana, which is, you can say, like a present day Tehsil or block. So Pargana, above Pargana we had Sarkar and then Suba. So that was the hierarchy in administration in medieval period. So this is a simple question from NCERT itself. Which among the following was associated as secretary with Hindu female school, which later became Bethune female school? So answer is Ishwar Chand Vidyasagar. He was a social reformer, calling for widow remarriage, women's education, stopping of sati, stopping of female infanticide. So C is the correct answer. If you know that Bethune school was formed around this time period, at that time we can say only Ishwar Chand Vidyasagar was active, a feminist or female activist acting for women's rights. So this is the most probable answer, or you may know this fact correctly. In the context of colonial India, Shahnawaz Khan, Prem Kumar Sehgal, Gurbakhsh Singh Dhillon, they are remembered as INA officers. So again, a simple question. The INA trials were in news a lot at that time, and we can see INA trials in all the standard textbooks like Spectrum, NCRT. So this is a very simple question from standard textbook from modern history. With reference to Indian history, which of the following statements are correct? So Nizamat of Arcot emerged out of Hyderabad state. So this is true. So we can see that this was a state of Hyderabad, and in Carnatic region there was this region of Arcot. So it became independent out of Hyderabad state itself. So this is true. In similar fashion, this was Vijayanagara Empire, and Mysore emerged out of Vijayanagara Empire only. So these two statements, they are true, and only A is the possible answer, because statement 1 and 2, they are given in statement in option 1 only. Rohilkhand Kingdom, again, it emerged out of in modern day North UP Uttarakhand region. So it emerged out of declining Mughal Empire only. So answer is A. Which one of the following statement is correct? So this is very random and very difficult question to attempt. So Ajanta caves, it lies in gorge of Bagora river. So we know that Ajanta is a rock cut stuck ancient Indian architecture, and it is there in Maharashtra, and it is having a horseshoe shape, and it lies in the river valley of Bagora. In Ellora also Bagora river is there. So Bagora river waterfall, you can say, in Ellora caves. So option A is correct. 21st February is declared to be International Mother Language Day by UNESCO, not UNICEF. So this is incorrect. UNESCO declared 21st February as International Mother Language Day in 1999. Statement 1 is incorrect. Statement 2 is correct. As we know that one of the major reasons for formation of Bangladesh is this conflict between Bangla and Urdu. And in Pakistan Constituent Assembly, this demand was raised to make Bangla national language. So statement 2 is correct. Answer is B. With reference to Chausat Yogini Temple situated near Morena, consider the following statement. So these are Chausat Yogini is a cult of Parvati. So this statement is incorrect. And we have many Chausat Yogini temples in India, one in Morena, Madhya Pradesh, other in Jabalpur, Madhya Pradesh also. So this was not the only circular temple built in India. So these were some kind of a circular structure, and this was dedicated to ancient medieval female yoga gurus, or it was linked to cult of Parvati. So statement 2 is incorrect, because it is the Chausat Yogini cult. It is having a lot of Chausat Yogini temples across the India. So it is not the only circular temple. So this statement is incorrect. Answer is C. Importantly, this Chausat Yogini temple structure is similar to Parliament building, and it is considered as a inspiration for Parliament building. Which one of the following ancient towns is well known for its elaborate system of water harvesting and management? by building a series of dams and channelizing water into connected reservoirs. So Dholavira is the correct answer. Recently only it got a World Heritage Site status and it is famous for its water conservation practices in ancient India. In the first quarter of 17th century, in which of the following places factories of English East India Company located? So only in Bharuch, Surat, Masulipatnam, we had English factories established between 1600 and 1650. Not in Chikkalpally, which is equivalent to modern Srikakulam in Andhra Pradesh, and Trichinopoly in Tamil Nadu. So answer is A. Next question, decline of Guptas and until rise of Pashvadana. So kingdoms that were active in northern India. So we had this time period from 300 AD to around 700 AD. So firstly, in this time period, we can say by common sense that at least dynasty of Harshvardhana was active. So that was Pushyabhutis of Thanesar. So we need option 3 in our statement 3 in our option. So B and C. Now, one additional information would be enough to answer the question. So Parmars of Malwa, they were active in medieval India from 9th to 14th century. So two we can eliminate. So if we eliminate two, answer is B. Next question. According to Portuguese writer Nunes, the women in Vijayanagar Empire were expert in which of the following? So Nunes has given extensive explanation or description of condition of women in Vijayanagar Empire. So women were very empowered during Vijayanagar Empire. They were involved in wrestling, astrology, accounting, soothsaying. So all of these statements are correct. Women used to guard palaces during Vijayanagar Empire. They were also judges in Vijayanagar Empire. So women were quite empowered during Vijayanagar Empire, and this was all documented by the Portuguese traveler Nunes. So answer is D. With reference to Madana Palle of Andhra Pradesh, which of the following statements is correct? So Madana Palle is famous for Rabindranath Tagore. So basically Rabindranath Tagore translated national anthem of India, Jangad Man, from Bengali to English at this place of Andhra Pradesh. So answer is C. Consider the following pairs. Historical place well known for. So Burja Home is well known for pit burials or pit dwelling, also for domestication of dog. So statement pair one is incorrectly matched. So three is definitely correct. Chandraketugarh in West Bengal is kind of a culture which was similar to Harappan civilization, and it is having a lot of terracotta art in this place. So answer is D. Consider the following statement. It was during the reign of Iltutmish that Genghis Khan reached the Indus in pursuit of fugitive Khwarizm prince. So this statement is correct. So, of statement 1 is correct. Genghis Khan came near to India during the reign of slave dynasty Sultan Iltutmish only. Second statement, it was during the reign of Muhammad bin Tughlaq that Timur occupied Multan and crossed the Indus. So, Timur occupied Multan around 1398. So, at that time, we had Nasruddin Muhammad in Delhi. So statement 2 is incorrect. Answer is A. Consider the following statement. Saint Francis Xavier was one of the founding members of Jesuit order. So this statement is correct. Saint Francis Xavier was one of the 7 founding fathers of Jesuit order. He brought this tradition to Goa also. However, he was traveling to China and in one of the island of the China, he died, and his mortal remains were brought to India, and there is a church dedicated to him in Goa, and every year we celebrate the feast of Saint Francis Xavier in the Goa. So only statement two is incorrect, as the Saint Francis Xavier, he died in island of China. So answer is C. Next question is related to systems of law in ancient India. So Mithak Sar was a civil law system in which sons could claim right to the property during the lifetime of father. Whereas in Daya Bhav, only after death of the father they had claim over the property. So in Mithak Sar system, by birth itself, children, sons, they got a right to the property. So statement two is correct. Both Mithak Sar and Daya Bhav, they deal with property rights of both male and female members. So statement three is incorrect. Both the systems of law, Mithak Sar and Daya Bhav, they are not linked to caste system, upper caste and lower caste. So answer is B only. With reference to India, terms halbi, ho, koi pertains to tribal languages. So halbi, ho, they are tribal languages of India. So answer is D. Consider the following statement in respect of Bharat Ratna and Padma Awards. So Bharat Ratna and Padma Awards, they are titles under Article 18(1). So this is incorrect. Assumption of titles violates right to equality, but there are certain exemptions, and Bharat Ratna and Padma Award, they are not considered titles under 18(1). So one is incorrect. Two is also incorrect, because Padma Awards have been suspended many times during emergency. So this is incorrect. Statement three, that is number of Bharat Ratna Award is restricted to maximum of 5 in a particular year. This is also incorrect, as it is restricted to 3 only. So all these statements are incorrect. Answer is C. So this is all from history discussion from prelims 2021 GS paper. In the next video, we will be discussing polity and economy. Thank you for joining the discussion.